गोपीजन वल्लभ गिरिवरधारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जनरंजन तीरवनचारी यमुना तीरवनचारी जयो राधा माधव कुंज विहार गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवरधारी यशोदानंदन ब्रज जनरंजन यमुना तीर वनचारी जयो राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी
जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रयोजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतश्री श्रीमद अभयचरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्लोक प्रभुपाद की इस्कॉन बीबीटी फाउंडराचार्य श्लोक प्रभुपाद की जय विष्णुपाद परमहंस प्रयोजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तर शतश्री श्रीमद भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज श्लोक प्रभुपाद की अनंत कोटि वैष्णववृंद की नामाचार्य श्लोक हरिदास ठाकुर की ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवत महापुराण की जय निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे समवेत भक्त श्री गुरु गौराम की जय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवतसेवया भगवती उत्तमश्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरुवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंट 1 चैप्टर 2 टेक्स्ट नंबर 10 चैप्टर entitled Divinity and Divine Service. Kamasya na indriya priti labha jiveta yavata jivasya tatva जिज्ञासा न अर्थ या च इह कर्म भी कामस्य निंद्रिय प्रीति लाभो जीवेत यावता जीवस्य तत्व जिज्ञासा नार्थो यश्चेह कर्म भी कामस्य निंद्रिय प्रीति लाभो जीवेत यावता जीवस्य तत्व जिज्ञासा नार्थो यश्चेह कर्म भी कामस्य नेन्द्रिय प्रीति लाभो जीवेत यावता जीवस्य तत्व जिज्ञासा नार्थो यश्चेह कर्म भी Matajis. Kamasya of desires, na, not, indriya, senses, pritihi, satisfaction, labha, gain, jiveta, self-preservation, yavata, so much so, जीवस्य ऑफ द लिविंग बीइंग तत्व द एब्सोल्यूट ट्रूथ जिज्ञासा इंक्वायरीज न नॉट अर्थ एंड यच इह व्हाटसोएवर एल्स कर्म भी बाय ऑक्युपेशनल एक्टिविटीज Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Life's desire should never be directed towards sense gratification. One should desire only a healthy life or self-preservation. Since a human being is meant for inquiry about the Absolute Truth, nothing else should be the goal of one's work. Purport. The completely bewildered material civilization is wrongly directed towards the fulfillment of desires in sense gratification. In such civilization, in all spheres of life, the ultimate end is sense gratification. In politics, social service, altruism, philanthropy, and ultimately in religion or even in salvation, the very same tint of sense gratification is ever increasingly predominant. In the political field, the leaders of the men fight over one another to fulfill their personal sense gratification. The voters adore the so-called leaders only when they promise sense gratification. As soon as the voters are dissatisfied in their own sense satisfaction, they dethrone the leaders. The leaders must always disappoint the voters by not satisfying their senses. The same is applicable in all other fields. No one is serious about the problems of life. Even those who are on the path of salvation, on the path of salvation, desire to become one with the Absolute Truth and desire to commit spiritual suicide for sense gratification. But the Bhagavatam says that one should not live for sense gratification. One should satisfy the senses only so much as required for self-preservation and not for sense gratification. Because the body is made of senses which also require a certain amount of satisfaction, there are regulative directions for satisfaction of such senses. But the senses are not meant for unrestricted enjoyment. For example, marriage or the combination of a man with a woman is necessary for progeny, but it is not meant for sense enjoyment. In the absence of voluntary restraint, there is a propaganda for family planning. But foolish men do not know that family planning is automatically executed as soon as there is search for absolute truth. Seekers of the Absolute Truth are never allured by unnecessary engagements in sense gratification, because the serious students seeking the Absolute Truth are always overwhelmed with the work of researching the truth. In every sphere of life, therefore, the ultimate end must be seeking after the Absolute Truth. And that sort of engagement will make one happy, because he will be less engaged in varieties of sense gratification. And what that Absolute Truth is explained as follows. Hare Krishna. One of our senior devotees, congregation member, which is a stalwart devotee, who is instrumental in building Radha Rasbihari temple, was directly helping His Holiness Girnath Swami Maharaj, and who is also High Court lawyer. I think you all imagine, is none other than Mahaprabhu Prabhu. In one Bhagavatam class, he was asking this question after the Bhagavatam class, right here sitting. And his question was, in fact, somebody asked this question to Mahaprabhu Prabhu, and Mahaprabhu was asking these questions to His Holiness Radhana Swami Maharaj. The question was, why in Srimad Bhagavatam so much of sense gratification is discussed? Why there is so much hue and cry about sense gratification? Then Maharaj replied, he said that Bhagavatam itself discusses sense gratification. And people in general, they never discuss sense gratification. Why? Because they only do it. They never discuss it. And we devotees, Maharaj said, we are supposed to discuss the ill effects of sense gratification. And Bhagavatam itself is doing it. So therefore, when we discuss sense gratification, that is only to give it up, never to engage in it. So therefore, in Srimad Bhagavatam, time and again, it is spoken so much about what are the ill effects of sense gratification, how to give it up. So while reading this purport, when I was trying to prepare for the class, I actually counted how many times Srila Prabhupada has written this word, sense gratification. You can also count it down. 13 times he has mentioned. How many times? 13 times. One single word, 13 times he is repeating after repeating. Why? Because to give us the emphasis how much it is very important to not to engage in sense gratification. So therefore it is said that self-realization and sense gratification will go ill together. They never go well together, they will go ill together, because you cannot combine them and lead one's life. Not possible. So after having answered the first two questions, Suta Goswami is now trying to explain in this verse the goal of occupational duties, the varana. And what is that? Athato brahma jignyasa, or jivasya tattva jignyasa, as it is mentioned in the verse. Jivasya tattva jignyasa. And then, when one engages in inquiring about the absolute truth, tattva jignyasa, then Prabhupada also mentioned the purport that the research work is so overwhelming that one will be fully engaged. And because he is fully engaged in higher activities, higher taste, there is no question of sense gratification, which is very lower. So once Srila Prabhupada asked this question by a scholar, he asked, Srila Prabhupada, what is the essence of all your teachings? You have written so many books, Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Yanodi, Yanvai, and so many other books. What is the essence of all of your teachings? Prabhupada quoted these two verses, yesterday's verse and today's verse. That kamasya na indriya priti labho jivete yavata. That the goal of one's life should be not to engage in sense gratification, but to inquire about the absolute truth. And yes, in order to inquire about the absolute truth, we have to have a healthy body. otherwise we won't be able to do that. Therefore, okay, maintain good health and then continue the work. Work, what is the work? Jivasya tattva jignyasa. So it is mentioned in second canto, wherein Mahavishnu, how he creates the primary creation, because he is the primary creator. First there is Pradhana, and Mahavishnu glances over it. When he glances over it, then the Mahatvatva, then the three modes of material natures are activated. Before that, nothing is happening. Only when the glance of Mahavishnu falls on material nature, then there is agitation, and thus the three modes of material nature are activated. And out of that, there are six elements are created by Mahavishnu's glance. And one of them is Ahankar, or false ego. This Ahankar, Mithya Ahankar, or false ego is so strong, and on this strong foundation, the entire material existence is built. What is the foundation? Mithya Ahankar, or false ego. And what is it? False ego is all about that I am the enjoyer and I am the controller. This is what it is all about. And the living entity, pure living entity, which is supposed to be serving the Supreme Lord in the spiritual world in pure love, gets affected by this insurmountable false ego, which makes him think that he is an enjoyer and he is a controller. And he comes to this material world and tries to enjoy the same sense gratification, the life after life of life, taking so many different kinds of lives. So therefore, the Lord comes to this material world and he cautions us and he advises us that Jivera Sarubhoy Krishnir Nityadas, that our constitutional position is to serve the Supreme Lord. And in all other yogas, whether it is Karma Yoga, Jnana Yoga, or Ashtanga Yoga, so there is a lot of doership mentality. And also to some extent, also enjoyership mentality is there. So therefore we see that so many people are taking to these three other kinds of yoga processes. So many people. However, it is very rare to see the people are taking to bhakti yoga process. Why? The obvious reason is that the foundation becomes, shaky. As soon as one walks into bhakti yoga school, what happens is that he is told that you are nobody. You have no existence. You have existence, but it's very, very minimal. Keshagra shatavagasya shatadakalpitasya. That is your existence. That is your size. And who is the Lord? He is Vibhu. And you are just Anu. So you now serve the Lord. So that means there is a big jolt on what? The entire foundation. What is that? False ego. And what is that false ego? I am the enjoyer, I am the maintainer, I am the controller. And that is why the material world is created, to facilitate the living entities to harbor such inimical desires. And therefore we see that very, very few people come to bhakti yoga. And we also see that very few people stay in bhakti yoga. And ultimately, very, very few people will succeed in bhakti yoga. Why? Because they cannot compromise with their false ego. फॉल्स यू गेट सच ए बिग अनर्थ इन द हार्ट दैट लिविंग एंटिटी इज विलिंग टू टेक बर्थ आफ्टर बर्थ गोइंग हियर देयर एवरीवेयर ऑल डिफरेंट यूनिवर्स सफरिंग थ्री फोल्ड मिजरीज एंड अंडरगोइंग अल्टीमेट सफरिंग ही डजंट माइंड दैट बट ही कैन नॉट गिव अ फॉल्स ईगो बिकॉज दैट इज द रूट ऑफ एंटायर मटेरियल एग्जिस्टेंस एंड वॉट इज भक्ति योग इज ऑल अबाउट टू कट डाउन इन टू पीसेस दिस फॉल्स ईगो देयर फॉर वेरी फ्यू पीपल कम हियर वेरी पीपल स्टे हियर एंड वेरी फ्यू पीपल बिकम सक्सीड सक्सेसफुल इन देयर एंडेवर्स नो प्रॉब्लम बट स्टिल द गोल इज द बेस्ट वॉट इज दट नॉट इंद्रिय प्रीति वेर इट इज मेन्शंड हियर वॉट इज दट कृष्ण प्रीति कृष्ण प्रेम सो बिकॉज द गोल इज सो वेरी एग्जॉल्टेड सो नो मैटर हाउ डिफिकल्ट इट इज नो मैटर हाउ मच डिफिकल्ट इट इज स्टिल दोज हु कम टू दिस भक्ति योग स्कूल आर सपोज टू परसू दर गोल दट इज कृष्ण प्रीति इंस्टेड ऑफ इंद्रिय प्रीति सो देर फॉर इन दिस वर्ल्ड पीपल वेन दे जनरली अड्रेस लेट अस से इन अ बिग गैदरिंग दे आर कॉल्ड एज लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन एंड एवरी वन बिकम्स enthralled, oh, we are being called as ladies and gentlemen. Even if they are going to sleep, then they become alert, okay, something is being addressed now. They are going to give us something. They are going to tell us something. They become alert. And let us say if there is a person who is driving a cab or a taxi, sometimes we call him taxi wala. And most of the times we call him a taxi, taxi, ajao. The taxi comes, the taxi wala comes. And he doesn't mind we calling him as taxi. Although is he a taxi? No, he is a taxi wala. He is supposed to be taking the taxi here and there. He doesn't mind even if you call him as taxi. Similarly, rickshaw wala. We call him rickshaw, rickshaw ajao. आ जाता है सीधा बताइए कहाँ लेकर आपको जाना है इट डजंट माइंड सिमिलरली वी व्हेन पीपल कॉल अस लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन वी डोंट माइंड वी एक्सेप्ट इट बिकॉज देर इज सो मच ऑफ आइडेंटिफिकेशन विद दिस मटेरियल बॉडी आई थिंक आई एम सो एंड सो आई एम मैन आई एम वुमन आई एम दिस एंड दैट एक्चुअली इट इज अ ग्रेट इंसल्ट फॉर अ लिविंग एंटिटी व्हेन समबडी कॉल्स अस with our, you know, these designations. But we don't mind because we have a kind of, you know, we have become accustomed to these kind of insults. Life after life, we have been called with the different names. We don't mind. So, these bodily identifications are very, very dangerous. Therefore, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, Jeeva Krishna Das, Ei Vishwas Karlo To Aar Dukkha Nahi. What is our real identification? Jeeva Krishna Das, we are servants of living, I mean, Supreme Lord. Ei Vishwas Karlo. Believe these words. विश्वास रखो इसके ऊपर एंड देन न दुख कर लो तो आर दुख ना ही ऑल आवर मिजरीज इन दिस मटेरियल वर्ल्ड आर ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ आवर मिस आइडेंटिफिकेशन एंड हिरण्यकश्यपु ऑल दीज नो ग्रेट डीमंस देर ओनली द गोल ऑफ देर लाइफ इज टू इंद्रिय प्रीति So Ekarat Vishaya Priyan. He was the entire, I mean, he was the emperor of the entire universe. And he enjoyed all kinds of sense gratification to the limits. And still he was not satisfied because Ajitendriya. So this is another problem with the sense gratification. What is that? No matter how much you feed these senses, they will never become satisfied. They want more and more. They demand more and more and more. And even Ravana, he was so, chivalrous, he fought with Yamaraj himself. He fought with Yamaraj. And of course, Yamaraj realized that, nobody can stand in front of Yamaraj. Yamaraj could have easily destroyed him. But at some point of time, Yamaraj realized that, no, I am not supposed to kill him, because Supreme Lord personally is going to come and he will kill him. He is not my share, he is Supreme Lord's share. So therefore, he retrieved kind of back. And Ravana, what he understood, see, I fought with Yamaraj. Yamaraj ran away from me out of fear of me. So that kind of gave him a lot of boost to again do his sense gratification, because there is nobody to kill me. The Yamaraj himself has ran back. So that means I am eternal. Nobody can kill me. Even Yamaraj has kind of ran back. So this enjoyer and controllership mentality is so dangerous that it can go to the extent of these great demons and trying to control the entire universe and then create so much havoc in this world for their own sense gratification. And another problem with this sense gratification is that you look at all these, great demons, the entire universe is worshipping them. It is said that even Narada Muni was, offering prayers to Hiranyakashipu. He was so great. What to speak of any other demigods? It is said that when he used to climb the throne and sit on his throne, big throne, he had made all these, devatas, the demigods has step. That means when he has to climb the throne, then these demigods had to bow down and he would put his foot on their heads and backs, then he would climb the stairs. That is how much he was powerful. But then one little Prahlad, he did not accept his authority. He became furious. He couldn't digest that. Entire world is worshipping him, including all the greatest of the demigods. Narada Muni himself is worshipping. But one little boy, his own son, he did not accept his authority. That was totally undigestible for him. He said, no, I cannot take it. So therefore, he kind of warring against his own son, and ultimately he was destroyed by none other than Lord Narasimha Dev. So this is the extent of false ego. What it can do to the humanity, we have already seen. The World War I was fought. For why? What is the reason? Because one party said that sense gratification should be done in this way. Another party said, no. We have to do sense gratification, but in that way. There is a conflict. And therefore, there is World War I. And then the same thing happened. What is that? World War II. What is the reason? The same reason. We should do sense gratification in this way. Somebody said, no, we should do it in that way. So therefore, there was World War II. And now we are preparing for the Third World War. And what will be the reason for this World War, if at all, if it happens? The same old stuff. Sense gratification should be done in this way, somebody will say. And somebody will say, no, 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 we should do it in that way. So therefore, there are going to be conflicts, and that will lead to the world war number 3. And in between, there are so many wars, Gulf Wars, Vietnam War, and this and that. All these wars are for what reason? Fought. Only one reason. Sense gratification. Some years before, we had the good fortune of hearing from His Grace Vijay Prabhu here, you know, Vijay Prabhu, Minister for Book Distribution. He was giving Bhagavatam class. He said that if you realize this one fact, what is the fact? That you are not the body, you are the spirit soul. If you realize this one fact, then it's such a big slap on the face of Maya. She will be bewildered when we realize that we are not the body. So therefore he quoted, Dehinosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yavanam jara tada dehantar prapti dhirastatra muheti. Who is a dhira, who is a sober person, who is a hero? One who has realized that he is not the body. Because as soon as that happens, the entire material existence starts shaking. That false ego, the biggest of the foundation on which the material existence is built upon, that starts shaking. So therefore, that is big slap on the face of Maya. She cannot tolerate that. Because who is he that who is going to slap me? She will certainly come with lot of more force and so many other things. So it becomes very difficult for her to digest. But nevertheless, we have to realize that who we are. And this material nature, Maya Devi, she has the same old stuff to offer. Why ghisa peta phuta parana? Why same thing? What is that? Sense gratification. Subtle and gross. Nothing more than that. Eating, sleeping, mating and defending. In these four things only entire material existence, they become shackled. And those who make it, those who conquer these four things, the so-called yogis and practitioners, renunciates, they some or other try to overcome these things. Sleeping, eating, all of that, four things. And for them, there is another thing, because she is Maya Devi, she is personally empowered by Krishna himself. She has all the power of Krishna to defeat the living entities. And now she has bigger arrows in her quiver. What are those? Three. Profit, adoration and distinction. Who can resist those? Who can say no to that? Somehow or other one may, with a lot of endeavors, can overcome the four problems. And there are three more available, three more waiting for us. Profit, adoration and distinction. And hardly anyone crosses them. Because that is so alluring, that is so satisfying. So therefore, you know, we have heard that some people, they always carry the resignation letter in their pocket. Istifa leke ghumte rehte wo log. Why? If somebody says that you are like this, you are like that, before they are fired out of their job, वो बोलते नहीं नहीं हमारे हाथ में क्या है इस्तीफा ये ले लीजिए आप हमको क्या नहीं कर सकते फायर नहीं कर सकते उसके पहले हम आपको निकाल देंगे हम आपके सर्वेंट नहीं है ना ही आप हमारे मास्टर similarly something like that the practitioners also are supposed to do. Before Maya Devi gives us a better, I mean so-called new life, with new body, we should be able to give her resignation letter. Enough of serving you. She is like a real taskmaster. What is her task? Her task is to offer newer, there is nothing new, the same old wine in new bottle, nothing new, the same old stuff. But what she does, she transfers from one universe to another universe with the same stuff, with newer body, newer location, but the same old stuff, sense gratification. And she's ready with her proposal, with everything is ready. As soon as we give up this body, she will offer a new body in a new location, in a new different universe, with new different prospects, but the same old stuff, sense gratification. And if you are not careful, then we'll get one so-called body to enjoy. So before that, we are supposed to tell her, enough of it. We are not going to take it anymore. So this is our resignation letter. You please accept it. Why? Because we have been employed by Krishna now. We are servants of Krishna. Jivyar Swarupaya Krishna Nityadas. So therefore, we are not going to serve you anymore. Thanks you very much. Hare Krishna. If you don't say that, then she is going to employ us in the same old stuff, sense gratification. So, her tricks are too many. Just like, you know, as soon as we get some new gadget, we become overwhelmed with it. So many features, so many apps and this and that. The camera is, you know, bigger version of, you know, mega, so many megapixels and this and that. So much. The same old stuff. Nothing more than that. But with little variations here and there. And that is so overwhelming. Whether it is gadget or whether it is a vehicle or home or this or that. She doesn't have to work hard to entice us. She doesn't have to work very hard to bewilder us. These little things are sufficient to bewilder any living entity in this world. And the attraction to these things, it quickly fades away. We have all realized it, isn't it? So we got our all new mobiles, newer version of the same one. We see 1, 2, 3 days, and after that, you keep it aside. There is no more attraction. There was attraction only in the initial stage. And later on, it is simply a botheration, and it is simply a liability. You have to take care of it now. There is no more attraction. No more it is an asset, but it becomes a liability. So similarly, whatever she offers, material nature, initially it is like a big asset, but soon it becomes liability. So, and this material body itself, it's such a fallible soldier that it gives all kinds of, you know, problems, and also it gives so many indications. The skin starts becoming wrinkled up, shriveling up, teeth, they are shattering, they fall apart, and the memory is getting, you know, weaker, strength is becoming lower and lower every now and then, day by day. And that should be sufficient for us to understand the fallible nature of this material world and material body. However, the living entity is so foolish, then what he starts doing is that now he becomes more energetic to squeeze out whatever little is remaining. Just like, you know, on the traffic signal, of course, there's a green signal, then there's a lot of rush to run fast. Similarly, in youth, there are a lot of vigor and strength to enjoy material senses. Okay, because abhi to hara bhara dikhta hai, theek hai, thoda der kar lete hain. Then it soon becomes yellow. What is the meaning of becoming yellow? Soon the red signal is going to come, isn't it? But as soon as the yellow signal comes, what happens, especially in India, we speed up. Actually, we are supposed to slow down, but opposite happens, that we speed up. Chalo, abhi ek do second mein main yahan se nikal jaun, to main nikal jaunga hamesha. Before it becomes red, it becomes yellow. That is supposed to tell us that now slow down, take back, come back, because the death is going to come. What is that red signal indicating? The death, inevitable, insurmountable. But living entity, as foolish he is, he tries to enjoy more and more. And in such a race, rat race, where is the question of tattva jignasa? There is an inquiry about everything else except absolute truth. Isn't it? Prabhupada used to say, the animals, they run on four legs, and we civilized human beings are running on four wheels. What is the difference? No difference. Only one business. What is that? Where is the sense gratification? Where is the sense gratification? From this universe to that universe, from another universe, we are traversing just to find this one thing. So therefore, the example of coconut is given in this regard. Coconut, when it is, you know, wet, I mean, the fresh coconut, if there is a pulp or this stuff within, and then we break it and we use to make our chutneys and this and that. But in order to separate that pulp or stuff out of that shell, it's a great endeavor, is it not? We have to have a sharp knife and to cut it off, the stuff. And only then that comes out, and then we can make something out of it. Because there is a lot of attachment to the shell. We are not the shell, we are living within the shell. We are the spirit soul. What is important, the shell or the stuff within? Not the shell. Shell, we throw it away. We use the stuff. And we are that stuff, the living entity. But what has happened is there is so much thick attachment. And Yamaraj has to come to separate this with Yamapash. Even then, we are not willing to give up. Just like that hard shell is so much attached. Rather, the stuff is so much attached to the shell that you have to bring a sharp knife to separate them. Such a hard endeavor, such a painful experience. And that is why death is so painful. Because there is so much attachment to the material body. Therefore, there is a liberation, something called as liberation. To liberate oneself doesn't have to give up this body. While living within this body only, we can realize that we are not the material body. That is possible. When we practice sadhana bhakti properly, then we can understand. When we reach higher and higher stages, we can realize that we are not the body. And in fact, as I said, these symptoms are sufficient also to realize that we are not the body. But the attachment is so thick, so dark, the living entity doesn't want to give it up. So then there is a separation, which is called as death. So painful, so excruciatingly painful. So therefore, sorry, before that time comes, we should separate ourselves from the shell. So therefore, sometimes when the inside stuff, it becomes dried up, then it gets separated from the shell itself, isn't it? Then how do we understand when we, you know, shake it, then there is a sound. What has happened is that inside, you know, stuff, it has become separated from the shell. Although it is within the shell, but it is no more connection, having any connection with the shell. And that is a state of liberation. One may be living in this material world, but still one can realize that I am not of this material world, neither I am this material body, rather I am the servant of God. And that is possible. And that is supposed to happen before we end our life. Then he is a person of, you know, of real devotion. That means he has achieved the perfection of one's life. So therefore sadhana bhakti is there. We are supposed to follow rules and regulations. And then the day will come once in one's life that one will soon realize that he is not the material body. So therefore, Krishna Swadhama Pagate Dharma Jnanadibhi Saha Kalau Nashta Drushamesha Puranarka Udunodita. So this Purana Srimad Bhagavatam is like a bright, brilliant sun, which is giving direction to one and all, whoever is willing to take it. And what is the direction Bhagavatam is giving? Right in this word, self-preservation, not sense gratification. Self-preservation is okay, it is allowed, but never sense gratification. And in the meantime, what? Do some tattva jignyasa. Do something substantial of inquiring about the absolute truth. That's what we are supposed to do. That is why we have come in this material world. Lord Krishna personally says to Uddhava, Nrideham adyam sulabham sudurlabham plavam sukalpam gurukaranadharam mayanu kolena nabhasvateritam puman bhavabdim nataretsa atmaha. That having achieved this material body, which is just like a boat, and having met with the great spiritual master, who is like a great pilot, captain. And there are favorable winds, which are like great Vedic literature, Srimad Bhagavatam, other Vedic literatures. Everything is favorable. Spiritual master is there. The scriptures are there. We have got this human form of life. And after having achieved all these things, if one doesn't do that tattva jignyasa, and then he is atmaha, killer of one's own self. That is how very strictly Krishna warns in Bhagavatam. So this is what Bhagavatam is indicating. And Srila Prabhupada also said, as I said in the beginning, this is the essence of all our teachings, Srila Prabhupada said. Today's verse and yesterday's verse. And therefore, Prabhupada mentions 13 times why one should not do sense gratification. Otherwise, the tendency is there. Tendency, what is the tendency? Again, it is explained in the 11th canto that three things why the living entity comes to this material world. Bhavaya, Amisha and Madhya Seva. Bhavaya is sex life. Amisha is meat eating. And Madhya Seva is intoxication. Living entity, which is so pure and taking pleasure in serving Krishna, comes to this material world only to enjoy these three abominable things. So therefore the tendency is there. So therefore Prabhupada has to time and again caution us He doesn't mind cautioning so many times because it's for our good. So therefore, when we walk towards North Pole, we are leaving away the South Pole. Towards North, there are all higher planetary system, and even Vaikuntha world is in the northern direction. That is like Krishna Prema, Krishna Preeti. Whereas Indriya Preeti is going down and down and down. When we go towards southern direction, we get to see what? All hellish planets are in the southern direction, as mentioned in Srimad Bhagavatam. So therefore, they are pole apart. Sense gratification and self-realization, they are pole apart. Either this one or that one. We cannot get the combination of both. And that is a disease of the living entity. He wants to do both. Because we have realized that, we should do some tattva jignyasa and do some service to Krishna, but we cannot just give up sense gratification. So then living entity thinks, okay, why not combine together? Let me serve Krishna, because that is the goal of life, but also let me continue with my old business. That is not possible. So therefore, Prabhupada says, sense gratification is condemned, not self-preservation. Okay, in order to live in this material world, we have to have material body, only then we can perform service, some service. Srila Prabhupada once, when he was talking to Dhananjaya Prabhu, his disciple in UK, and he was telling him, there are 3 S in Krishna consciousness. 3 S formula. What is that? First S is for swasthya. Second S is for sadhana. And third S is for seva. Only when then there is swasthya, then we can do some sadhana, and then there is question of any seva. 3 S. Prabhupada said this to Dhananjaya Prabhu. So therefore, swasthya first. First, we have to have good health. Only then we can do some good sadhana. And sadhana, when we perform nicely, then the seva comes. Generally what happens, we first start doing a lot of seva, which is anyway very good, we should do seva. But not at the cost of sadhana and swasthya. When sadhana is compromised and swastha is compromised, then seva will not happen for a long time. So therefore, self-preservation, Prabhupada is saying it. Prabhupada told, take good care of health. Therefore, he always wrote, your ever well-wisher. What is he wishing well? Then he said that, he also wrote, hope this letter meets you in good health. Isn't it? He wrote it down. Whenever he wrote letters, that means he wants us to have good health so that we can do some nice sadhana and then some seva. So it is very interestingly, when we first time heard the name Seva Sthan in our temple, previously we had Seva Sthan near Sharanagati library. So those devotees who become sick, so they are given medical aids and treatment. And Maharaj, His Holiness Radhana Swamaraj, he said that it should be called as Seva Sthan. I mean, we are wondering, what is Seva Sthan all about? It's Swasthya Sthan, Swasthya, because we are going to regain our Swasthya health. It should be Health Sthan or Swasthya Sthan. And Maharaj very surprisingly gave the name Seva Sthan. Why? The seva is the goal. Why I am entering into seva sthan? Because I want to do more seva, and presently my body is not very healthy. So therefore I am going to seva sthan so that I can get some swasthya. Then I will do some sadhana so that then I will render some seva So therefore it is, I am entering into Sevasthan. So very well thought about idea, isn't it? Sevasthan. So Prabhupada, being a founder Acharya of ISKCON, he has taught us by his own example. Every morning he got up, he did morning walk every single day. And it is said that when he used to walk, all his Americans and European disciples, they had to literally run behind him. He used to walk very fast. Early morning, Prabhupada said, early morning sun gives you energy. So when we walk in early morning, that gives a lot of strength, good health. And then Prabhupada took oil massage. Personally, he preferred it. And then he was following his diet. He has given us everything by his own example. How we can have swasthya or good health so that we can do our service. And no question of sense gratification. Prabhupada, we see that he traversed 14 times at the age of 70 plus to carry out the mission of ISKCON all over the world. Who can do it? Who has done it? Apart from Srila Prabhupada. And every gesture of his indicates that how much he was detached. He was one Guru Puja, he is taking Charanamrit. We all take Charanamrit. One devotee was giving him Charanamrit. He gave him Charanamrit. Prabhupada sipped it. He liked the taste of Charanamrit. He said, very nice Charanamrit. This devotee realized, oh, Prabhupada liked the Charanamrit. So let me give him more. So he was trying to dip his, spoon. And he got up and he sees Prabhupada has already walked away. He didn't stand, okay, let me have one more sip. No. He took Charanamrit, he appreciated the taste of Charanamrit, but didn't stand there to take another sip, another spoon of Charanamrit. He just walked away. Can you imagine the kind of detachment? Where is the question of sense gratification? Yes. Krishna's Mahaprasad is there, we are supposed to taste it and appreciate it, but not for sense gratification, but for self-preservation. And Srila Prabhupada again in Kumbh Mela, now devotees have gone to Kumbh Mela in Vrindavan. This Kumbh Mela was in original place where Prabhupada with his disciples, one morning he was walking. And he saw all these big Mahamandaleshwar sadhus. They were sitting on their big elephants. And they are all going to Shahi Snan. They are going for bathing ceremony. And all these disciples, they got excited. They said that, Prabhupada, we'll also bring next time elephant. So we'll also make you sit on the elephant so you can also go for Shahi Snan. Prabhupada said, yes, we should bring elephant, but who should sit on the elephant? Radha and Krishna should sit on the elephant. Then I'll walk along with the elephant. We'll all go to take bath. So that means what? Although he's a founder Acharya, he is teaching by his own example. No. We are not supposed to do all of this. We are supposed to, glorify Krishna, and then we are just his servants. So therefore, time and again, Srila Prabhupada has given us the indications, teachings, and in his purports, he time and again tells what is necessary is to self-preservation, not sense gratification. So therefore, this Srimad Bhagavatam is Amalam Puranam. I'm taking a little longer. I'm just going to end. that it doesn't spare anybody. Bhagavatam is like a testing stone, where you test what you think is gold. You bring your gold, and here is Srimad Bhagavatam, you test it. All the devotees who are like supposed to be pure gold, they are tested whether it is Lord Brahma, the greatest of all the demigods, whether he is Lord Shiva, who is Gunavatar, and whether Indra, Chandra, Agni, Vayuvarna, Brihaspati, Vishwamitra, Shaubhari Muni, or Pururava, whoever he is, they all have to come and test themselves in front of Srimad Bhagavatam. And then they will understand who are they. Kaun kitna pani mein hai, wo pata chal jayega. Because Bhagavatam doesn't spare anybody. So therefore it's Amalam Puranam. And all these great souls, whether it's Brahma, Shiva, Indra, Chandra, Agni, Varan, Vayu, I mean all these great souls, they have given their realization that what is one's goal of life, how one should conduct. And they have given out, poured out their realization, Srimad Bhagavatam, here and there, everywhere. They all tell that, you know, there's no point in spending time here doing all this cheap stuff, sense gratification. Rather, one should do the highest, that is, Tattva Jignyasa, Absolute Truth, serving the Absolute Truth. And that is the goal of one's life. So, and also Lord Brahma studied, it is said, 3 times Srimad Bhagavatam. Because every scholar studies any scripture 3 times, so that you will understand the essence of it. First he studied, then he realized that Karma Yoga is not an essence of life. Then he studied Jnana Yoga, he realized that that is not it. Third time he studied, he realized that Bhakti Yoga is the essence of Srimad Bhagavatam. Then he has given his verdict that service to Krishna, pure devotional service, is the essence of one's life. And when we perform our pure devotional service in the association of devotees, then love of God is achieved, and that is the success of one's life. So I would like to end at this point of time. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. Shrimad Bhagavat Mahapurana ki jaya, Srila Prabhupada ki jaya, Nitai Gaura Premanande, Hare Krishna.